One of the joys of traveling is trying all that local food. Tonight, Pamela Young travels through Japan in search of the perfect mixed plate. Pam.
Thanks, Marissa and Howard. It doesn't come any closer to perfect than in Japan, where presentation, taste, and nutrition are the focal points of any meal, whether you're in a five-star restaurant or barbecuing in your backyard. Tonight, we grind.
When the sakura are blooming, it's time to bring out the hibachi. Roasted rice balls go well with just about anything. In Busan, it wouldn't be a picnic without teriyaki and taiko. I'm advised not to quit my day job. All that percussion builds up the appetite for our next stop, Beppu. The Hatto Matsuri has summoned paraders to downtown, so we opt to stay indoors. In this town, there's nothing like room service. Japanese beef with a tricolor of peppers cooked over slow heat. Tempura veggies straight from the fields. Steamed fish head and shiitake. A bubbling nabe of tofu and seafood. Thai sashimi. Busan conch and, whatever. Pining for poultry, we ventured to Kyoto's Tsukada Nogyo for Kyushu grilled capon thighs, choice some egg yolk, and something you won't see in the U.S., seared chicken sashimi. Food regulation here allows for raw poultry, meat, and fish. And ready for a midnight mixed plate? Hoi expat Jenna Hayama takes us to Shinjuku for ramen.
How often do you have ramen?
I would say maybe at least once a week. The package kind I would maybe eat twice a week.
That's a lot of ramen.
Yeah, it is.
And why shouldn't she? At $2.30 a bowl, good to the last sip of soup.
Our mixed plate special under a sakura sky tomorrow night at 9:30. I'm hungry all over again. Pamela Young, KHON2 News.